Hello, in this video, I'm going to go over how to use the new Haas remote jog handle, the RJH-XL, on your Haas mill. The RJH-XL gives you access to many essential control functions while allowing you to get in close or get a different angle on your setup and still control machine motion. And with the RJH-XL, the screen is now 60% larger and features an e-stop right on the pendant. You can manually jog in zero return axes, set tool and work offsets, turn on and off coolant, open and close vices, command tool changes, and even run your program all through the pendant. These are all really great features that can help shops run faster and better. So let's get into how to use these features on the RJH-XL. The main display of the RJH displays the current program loaded as well as the current machine position. The position can be displayed as a position from the work offset, distance to go, machine position, and operator mode by selecting the different display modes on top of the screen. Additionally, you can choose to turn on or off single block, option stop, block delete, and the coolant using the buttons on the bottom of the screen. And in the bottom corner of the screen, you can press the menu button to open up the main menu of the RJH. On the main menu, you can select between several different functions: manual jogging, set tool offsets, set work offsets, zero return, auxiliary menu, utility menu, and work holding. The utility menu simply displays the RJH's software and firmware information, so we won't cover that in this video. But let's get started on the first and most common use function, manual jogging. Manual jogging is the equivalent to the handle jog mode on the control. On the top of the screen, select the increments you would like to jog in. On the bottom, toggle between the different position display modes: work offset position, distance to go, machine position, and operator mode. Then, select the axis you would like to move and use the jogging wheel to move the axis you selected. Additionally, you can use the arrows on the pendant to jog the axes, with the right arrow moving the axis in the positive direction and the left arrow in the negative direction. In between those two buttons is the rapid jog button, and when it is held down at the same time as the jog direction, the machine will rapid jog at 2x the max jog speed in the direction that the arrow is pointing. To exit, press the menu button and it will take you to the main menu. Selecting set tool offsets opens up the tool offset function. In this mode, you can jog and control all the axes and jog rates as you would in manual jogging. However, rather than pressing the display on screen, press F1 and F3 to cycle through and select the axis you would like to jog. The tool you have loaded in the spindle will show on screen with its tool offset displayed below, followed by the length of the tool and the coolant position, all of which are equivalent to what is displayed on the offsets page. To set the tool length offset, jog the tool into position and press set L. The tool offset number, length, and coolant position can all be modified by pressing adjust. With one of them selected, press adjust and then use the jogging wheel to adjust the field to the value of your choosing. This is especially helpful when setting up tools using something like a shim, where you want to subtract the thickness to get an accurate tool offset. If your machine has programmable coolant, you can adjust the spigot position by highlighting the coolant position value, pressing adjust, and changing it to the value of your choosing. You can press the M8 button to turn on the coolant and then again to turn off. Finally, once you have finished setting up the tool, you can press the next button to command a tool change to the next successive tool and continue setting up your tools. Back in the main menu, selecting set work offsets opens up the work offset function. Similar to the tool offset function, you can control all the axes using manual jogging and toggle between the different axes using the F1 and F3 buttons. Press the work number button to use the jog wheel to cycle through the different work offset numbers. Press enter to select the offset number you would like to use. The offset values for that work offset are displayed in the X, Y, and Z fields, which are the same values displayed in the offset page of the control. To set a new work offset, load up whatever calibration tool you would like to use and move it into position. Once in position, select the axis you would like to set and press the set button. Then, if using a tool like an edge finder, you can adjust the offset value by pressing adjust and using the jog wheel to change the value by your desired amount, pressing Enter to confirm. You can then repeat this for all your work offsets. Next up is the zero return function. To zero return a single axis, select the axis you would like to return and press the single button. However, regardless of which axis is highlighted, the all button will zero return and feed all axes in the following order: Z, X, and Y. This is similar to pressing the power up button when powering up the machine. Lastly, the per button will rapid all axes to their home position and load the program in memory. From here, all you need to do is press cycle start on the pendant to run your program. Finally, the last two functions are the auxiliary menu and the work holding functions. The auxiliary menu allows you to control the spindle and coolant in the machine. Pressing the spindle button will give you the ability to rotate the spindle clockwise or counterclockwise and then stop it when done. The spindle speed is determined by whatever speed it was last run at. You can overwrite that speed by typing in the desired spindle speed into the control and pressing either forward or reverse. Once finished, you can press the back button to return to the auxiliary menu. In here, like in other menus, you can press the M8 button to turn the coolant on and off. In opening up the work holding function, it displays the work holding connected to the machine. By selecting the specific work holding you would like to control, press the clamp button to clamp the work holding and again to unclamp it. Beyond just controlling the machine, the RJH-XL makes it simple to control a robot or APL, increasing your machine performance and productivity. But even on standard machines, the pendant makes it easy to have the functionality of the control at your fingertips, even if you can't be in front of it. For more information on the RJH-XL, visit haascnc.com, and I'll see you next time.